지금 인권 모략가들에 의해서 놀아나는 박연미의 정체를 까밝힌 우리의 편집물 인권 모략국의 꼭두각시 박연미가 인터넷을 통해서 세상에 나가자 세상 사람들과 언론들에서 박연미의 거짓말에 경악을 금치 못하고 있지 않습니까?
네, 옳습니다. 미국을 비롯한 초종 세력들은 제놈들의 인권 모략이라는 쪽배가 이미 신동엽에 의해 구멍이 뚫렸는데 박연미로 해서 더 큰 파열구가 나고 북인권보고서가 쓰레기통에 처박히게 되자 아우성을 치면서 어떻게 하나 그것을 막아보려고 헤덤벼치고 있습니다. 특히 다루스만이나 마이클 커비와 같은 자들은 매일과 같이 인간 쓰레기들을 끌고 여기저기 싸다니며 그 무슨 해명이니 반박이니 하며 소란을 피우고 있습니다.
예. 박연미 아버지 박진식의 문제도 계속 내들고 있지 않습니까?
예, 그렇습니다. 그래서 이번에 우리는 박진식을 비롯해서 박연미 가족의 행적을 더 파헤쳐보았는데 어물더미는 들출수록 썩은 내가 더 난다고 박연미가 그처럼 애정을 표시하는 아버지 박진식은 그 어느 나라에서도 용서받을 수 없는 인신 매매 행위에 가담한 반인륜적인 국제형사범이고 그의 어머니와 친척 등 박연미 일가 족속들도 상상을 초월하는 인간 추물들이라는 것이 더욱 낱낱이 드러났습니다.
그런 더러운 족속들 속에서 자라난 박연미가 인간 쓰레기로 될 수밖에 없는 것은 자명하지 않습니까?
예, 옳습니다.
결국 박연미는 인간 어물더미에서 돋아난 독버섯이라고 해야 할 것입니다.
그렇습니다. 우리는 이런 인간 어물더미 위에 인권이라는 비단 보자기를 씌워보겠다고 발광하는 모략꾼들이야말로 그 얼마나 가련하기 짝이 없는 자들인가를 세상이 똑똑히 알게 하기 위해서 박연미와 그 일가 족속의 추악상을 다시금 파헤치는 이 편지물을 제작했습니다.
Early last year, in an interview with a libertarian radio station in San Francisco, US, Park Yun-mi said she and her parents, three of them, had crossed a river to reach China where her father's business partners were waiting for them with their cars. Then in the One Young World Summit held in Dublin, she said she and her mother, just two of them, had escaped. And then in another interview with Marianne Jolly, an Australian broadcast journalist, Park said she had buried her father at night all by herself. She told a different story to other journalists that her father's body had been cremated. In the Dublin One Young World Summit, she said she had buried her father alone at 3 a.m. After 3 months, in an interview with The New Focus, she said she had held her father's funeral with the brokers, and she had even asked a favor from one of the defectors called Kim Hee-won to support her statement. All the stories told by Park Yun-mi about her parents are lies. Her parents were freaks who hated each other and both had affairs with others. In the end, they had an ugly divorcement. In one of her lies, Park said that about 8 kilometers from Haesan in Ryanggang province, there is a Juche rock in a peak of a mountain called Gotdongji in Gumsan-ri. She said if you look down from that mountain peak, you can see Bongsu-ri of Bochon County and Amnok River. She said she took that route to escape. But in fact, there is a highway from Haesan to Bochon County, and just on its left side, there is a small rock called Juche rock. And if you look down from there, the opposite side is Jiangbai County of Jilin Province, China. On the far other side of Amnok River, you can see not the Bongsu-ri of Bochon County, but Yeonpungdong, Haesan City. So how on earth did she manage to find a mountain here in the region, which she said to have crossed at the risk of her life? Now let's take a look at the family photos showed by Park Yun-mi in an interview with The New Focus on 2nd of February as a proof to a story that she had stayed in China with her father. The photos were taken with different people from different angles at different periods, but the eyes, the nose, and the mouth of the father is exactly the same in all three pictures. In particular, considering that she had said the first photo was taken just before he died, and the rest were taken soon after he came to China, there is 4 months gap, and yet her father in the photos looks exactly the same in each one of them. This makes one wonder whether the photos are of the real Park Jin-sik. No, the pictures are trick photographs. It is so slushy play to comment on. Did they really believe that they could deceive anybody with such photos? It's no wonder that The Diplomat carried an article on December 10th that read, "The whole world is dancing to the tune of the little girl," to which the readers replied as follows. If they did it in innocence, they must be fools. If they did it on purpose, they must be cunning cheaters. The whole world is being deceived by such frauds. This is true. She is left with no choice but to tell those absurd lies and even shed crocodile tears in order to be worth the money she had received from the plotters, when all she's got is a vague memory of a 13-year-old and a low IQ.
Yeah, 걔 여기서 떠나기 전 행가 막 울면서 학교 갔다 오는 게 막 울면서 와서 여미야 여미야 어라 어라 왜 우니 하니까 하늘에서 그 우박이 떨어지니까 하늘에서 돌멩이로 날 때린다 하는 정도의 사고 됐는데 그걸 걔네는 이제니까 10살까지도 어서 못 싸서 계속 포단을 바깥에다 놀댔습니다.
박연미 14살인데 우리 둘째 아이도 14살이고 같았다 말입니다. 근데 할머니 집에 이자겐 아파트 1층에 갔다가 9시 10시 때 이렇게 올라오는데 8층 층계 이렇게 타 올라서는데 그 이렇게 이 층계기 층 유리 있는데 거긴데서 아니 거꾸라고 남자 있어 이렇게 있더란 게란 말입니다. 그래서 자기는 살랑살랑 올라가다 보니까나 옷을 보니까 여미더란 게란 말이. 그래서 집에 들어와서 하 통쾌하게 웃는다 말 집에 들어와서 한번 못 보고 아니 왜 그러니 가 좀 웃는 게 좀 통쾌하게 웃나 보니 너 왜 그러니까나. 이미 이제 어떤 청각이 자꾸 끌어안고 있는다기라 말이게 야, 니 그거 말이야 하니 이제 12살인 게 뭘 알아서 남자를 알아서 그러간다. 아이 이거 막 진짜라고 진짜라.
Such is Park Yeon-mi, who is born vile and knows no disgrace. She didn't hesitate to say that her mother Byun Gum-suk was raped by a broker during the Dublin One Young World Summit. No matter how much the broker requested, what kind of a mother would make such acts in front of her own daughter?
There is a thing in North Korea.
This makes people wonder whether it was a shallow wit to shock the people with her so-called testimony. Or if that really happened, then it clearly shows that Byun Gum-suk is such a pervert. To begin with, she is already a known nymphomaniac. Let's listen to what her neighbors have to say about Byun Gum-suk.
Byun Gum-suk이는 이제니까 사치를 좋아하고, 예, 그래서 남보다 특이한 거 입어야 되고, 소굴초에 가서 소굴지도 하고, 소굴지도한 놈하고 눈이 맞아서, 예, 소굴지도 하고는 우리 가만히 있어 보면 대문을 걸면 한번 훌떡 모이 시꺼먼 게 너무 떼서 내 문 열어 보니까 남자가 들어와서 아 이건 뭐인가고 이러니까 아 이 집에 들어왔다 그래서 이 집에 남편 없는데 왜 이 아니 밤중에 지금 몇시길래 여자 혼자 사는 집에 들어나 그 이튿날 아침에 내가 야 너 운명의 아버지한테 내가 특별과업도 받아서 너 좀 그렇게 놀지 말라 어? 야 너 뭐이 부족해서 네 생활이 뭐이 부족해서 그래 그러니까 그놈아 그놈아 너무 간섭하지 마 우미 엄마 바람 저 우미 아버지 바람 쓰는데 어 나라고 못 쓰겠어 근데 또 갔다 와서 때리고 치고 또 싸움하는데 박진식인 여기 나와서 싸움하면 또 날 꼭 불러갑니다 그럼 내 또 떼나가면 또 그놈아 이거 보라고 우리 엄미가 말한대 하면 누가 와자고 누가 와자 뭐 자다 한다고 또 이러면 또 때리고 치고 싸움하지
Byun Gum-suk had already divorced her husband Park Jin-sik. Here is the record of the decision of the People's Court of Haesan City on April 6, 2006. Just as if to prove this, Byun Gum-suk wrote as follows in her letter she sent at the end of March 2007 to a woman called Sugyong, who had an affair with her former husband Park Jin-sik and lived in Daebongwook's district. To Sugyong, what irritates me is what you said to me in front of my former in-laws. You said you should stop stealing. Why don't you live with him yourself? This is one sentence that you said. That really struck me and I didn't know what to say. If I were to live with Eun-mi's father, then I wouldn't have introduced you to him. I was mortified. As is seen from the letter, Byun Gum-suk was a friend of Sugyong, the woman who had an affair with her husband. They frequently fought over money and men, and when Sugyong insisted that Byun Gum-suk stole from her, they had a row. Byun Gum-suk then wrote a letter to Sugyong saying, "If I were to live with Eun-mi's father, I wouldn't have introduced you to him." Eventually, Byun Gum-suk was handing over her husband to a friend as if he were a toy. The woman referred to as Sugyong is a felon who had been involved in human trafficking together with Park Jin-sik and ran away. This is the truth. Is Park Yeon-mi aware of this shabby and despicable criminal career of her mother? Park Jin-sik, father of Park Yeon-mi, is even a worse criminal. As is widely known, he had been sentenced to 10-year imprisonment for smuggling important assets of the state, and he was later released on sick bail. But instead of working hard to make up for his past crimes, he committed another serious crime such as human trafficking. When Park Jin-sik was released on sick bail, he stayed with his elder brother Park Jin, where he received medical treatment for some time. He then moved to another place with the help of his friend Chang Sun, and we visited that house in People's Neighborhood Unit No. 10 in Yonghongdong, Haesan City. The people in that village told us about their heartbreaking tragedies of having lost their little daughters by Park Jin-sik.
Haruno, Soraya, Isimiro, no Imlake Madang and Naura,
이 굴더랍니다. 그래서 양이 이민학교 마당에 몇 시까지 나오라. 나오라니까 이 아저씨만에 나오라. 굴더랍니다. 그래, 아저씨만에 나간 게, 날이 좀 어둡기 전이더라 말입니다. 그래서 아들이 거기 서 있는데, 천상 나타나더랍니다. 그래서 자기는 아홉 시까지 있다가 이 집에 집에 갔다는 게라 말입니다. 그래, 그랬는데, 그 후지게 이렇게 3일이다가 야내로 훌 빼는데, 그 후지게 말하는 사람 말하는 게, 이민학교 마당에 계단 놓고, 그 주위 이 주재원들이 내복했는가. 이거 다 이렇게 여행하고, 박진 씨가 려련하다는 건 이루 말할 수 있단 말입니다. 그렇게 하고, 야는 분소다가 어디가 내통한 게 없구나 하고서 그 다음번에 마음 놓고 뽑았다는 게란 말입니다. 근데 후지게 10월 13일 때, 이렇게 박진 씨기네 그 진동에 살 때 앞집에 있는 여자가 자기 딸이 없어서 막 와서 말하는 게, 자기네 딸들도 인물 심사하는 게, 이 여기 장마당을 여기서부터 쭉 뒷선으로 한번 노란 옷 입고, 노란, 위에 노란 옷 입고 까만 바지 입고 둘이서 왔다 갔다 두 번 하라 그러더랍니다. 그러면 거기서 다시 인물 심사했다는 겁니다. 이 매대에 서서 아이들을 그렇게 해서 보냈다 그 집 아이들. 내가 알고 있는 상태는 그저 우리 아이들 둘이다가
그다가 니 세워라
저기서 뭐야 예, 일심이 은저이 은저이란 아 간에 둘 형제간이 박지식이랑 딸이 나이 둘이 다 같단 말입니다. 박지식이는 큰딸이 17살이고 이 집 아이들 15살 둘 다 하나국이랍니다. 큰 아이들도 하나국끼리 작은 아이들 하나국끼리 근데 그렇게 양해보고 벌써 2006년도에 왔을 때 중국 가자꾸더랍니다. 영순이도 갔지.
어쨌든 그 공세 엄마 계속 댕기다 말이야.
공세 엄마가 다니는 게 거기 광시하고 그런 전형에.
어쨌든 여기 내 좀 마당에 있을 때 그 이민이 왔으니 어디 가는 건데 이 아파트
팔지 말라고 한다. 이연이 부야라 그 이사로 판 사람이 많았다 말인데.
그 니 둘이 결탁해서 계속 좀 웃는 게구나.
박정박이 이민이라 다 그거라 보냈다 말.
그저 막 맷돌에 그저 기기다 막 갈아치웠으면 좋겠습니다. 막 쓰지 않겠습니다. 그래도 막
그거 뺏기고. 그 소음 타던 생각하면에. 그저 보기 마음은 그저 저 말입니다. 그저 나 잡아가듯이 잡아가고 그저 칼 쥐고 그저 막 찍기 시킵니다. 이상 보기 마음은
뭐 자다가도 예, 자다가도 정신병자 전부 잠으로 하려고 예. 밑에서래 엄마 잔 자기들 자다가 한가게서래 그렇게 하고 미쳐서래 막 우린 야 정신 도는가 했습니다. 그리고 옆에서도 막 그저 막 어떻게 하냐 어서는
그저 이 사람들이 많아서
그래서 데리고 내 여기 데리고 있을 수도 있습니다. 데리고 있자가 아들 올까봐
예? 네 제발
걱정 뒤서 괜찮습니다.
내 이 집 뚫어 날까지 불을 못 쓰겠습니다. 왜 그런가 아이들이 바짝 꼭대기 올려보고 우리 집이 불이 켜 엄마 있구나 하는 거 보고 다 올라올 것 같아서 불을 못 쓰겠습니다.
그 생각하면 그거야 정말.
We would like to ask to the U.S. and its followers, isn't it already a crime itself to provide shelter to the criminals? Instead of bringing justice to such criminals as the family members of Park Yeon-mi, the U.S. and its followers are supporting them to use those criminals as servants in achieving their despicable aim of regime change in the DPRK. Isn't this clearly showing that you are the ringleader of crimes? Park Yeon-mi is saying that she herself is the victim of the human trafficking of the brokers, but it is a sheer lie. Park Yeon-mi's father, Park Jin-sik, had contacts with the head of the brokers, who was manipulated by the South Korean criminal group engaged in human trafficking under the cloak of religion. He used his contact to sell the children of other families, but when it came to his own daughters, he made sure that they were well off with the money he earned by selling the other kids. This was already proved by Park Yeon-mi, who said in an interview with The New Focus that she had lived in a house of a rich person in Shenyang after the escape, spending a lot of money. As is shown by the witnesses of the villages, it is Han Jong-dok and Ton Yong-ae who had connected Park Jin-sik with the head of the broker of human trafficking. They were given a stern trial according to the criminal code of the DPRK on February 25, 2008. Pyeon Jong-sik, uncle of Park Yeon-mi, and the second elder brother of Pyeon Gum-suk, is also a criminal. While working as a worker in the Pungnam mine, he was admitted to the reform institution for charges of theft of state and personal property on 17 occasions, as well as assault on two people. Later, while working in the land development station in Gowon County, he alone, or in conspiracy with others, committed theft of state and personal property and served 4 years in the reform institution since July 1, 1992, according to the Article 56, Paragraph 2, and Article 155, Paragraph 2 of the DPRK Criminal Code. Park Dong-il, uncle of Park Yun-mi, is another criminal. While working as a teacher in Sapo District, Hamong City, he was subjected to 20-year imprisonment for rape and murder of his student. He was admitted to the reform institution in July 1980 and was later released by amnesty in February 1992. As such, Park Yun-mi is surrounded by criminals and family. So it is no wonder that she grew up to be such a human scum. And it is only natural that Park's family had fled to the stinking capitalist habitat, having failed to fit into our healthy society where true human beings live. In the DPRK, generous amnesty is granted to those who had been punished for having committed crimes by believing in their conscience. Even if anyone had fled the country, their relatives are not affected and are treated as if nothing happened.
그때 당시에 리우나 여사 벌써 리우나비던데 여사는 이 남편에 대한 정도 없었단 말입니다. 이렇게 다생할 수가 없고 여기 떠날 때 당시도 아, 싸움에서 우리가 말라 가서 가보니까 온데 뜯겨서 애미 딸 달라붙어 해변에서 그게
오지 야 같은 건 여기 우리 사회주의자에서 살 때부터 이 머리 상태가 변질됐고 돈밖에 모르고 그걸 김혜야 어디서 계승받았는가 부모들한테서 계승받았단 말입니다. 우리 제도에서는 이거 사람 새끼를 알아. 우리 형제 자체도 사람 새끼를 보지 않았습니다.
나는 하기 싶은 말은 뭔가, 야, 행복과, 어? 복속에서 사는 게, 예? 그런, 예?
입에 담지 못할 그런 거짓말을 할 수 있나? 거짓말인가?
나 기진, 그거만 응? 이거. 어. 인간 아니다, 너는, 응?
그게 검은 못세여도 말이야.
욕청 되지 말아야지.
욕청은 되지 말아야지, 응?
This is the reality. Nevertheless, the US and its followers are still beating the worn-out drum by dragging Park Yun-mi to the stage repeatedly. Now that Park Yun-mi's so-called testimonies were proved to be lies, just as Shin Dong-hyuk, who tried to fool the world media and truth, she has become the international target of disgrace. And the anti-DPRK human rights drama directed by the US and its followers is on the verge of utter failure. This has pushed them to make desperate efforts to cook up more lies. It is said that the Penguin Random House of US would soon be publishing the memoirs of Park Yun-mi. The life and soul of media is truth, objectivity, and fairness. So when the Penguin Random House fails to adhere to these principles and publishes such a book full of lies, it is doomed to become a laughingstock of the whole world and eventually meet its tragic end of having to discontinue publication itself, missed by no readers. Lies can never hide the truth. All the honest people of the world should not be played by the vicious anti-DPRK human rights racket by the US and its followers, aimed at regime change in a sovereign state. They should clearly see through the true characters of the plotters who are acting behind the screen of human rights, and raise their voices for justice and truth in order to protect the world from the lies and plots cooked up by the US and its followers. If the hostile forces, including the US, choose to continue the human rights drama of human dregs that dares to sling mud to the DPRK, we will give them a super hard counterblow and disclose the truths of their lies. They should realize that only more disgrace and utter failure is in store for them and stop behaving arbitrarily.